a steering wheel, for passionate drivers, is a lot more than just an object which steers your car. For enthusiasts like me, a steering is the interface which connects us to our cars. I realized I hadn't made a tech review in quite some time, and today's video is all about the Golf Market's fancy new electronic steering wheel which I've tried and tested in a Polo and a Tiguan. So Volkswagen, on their newest platforms, are trying to do away with conventional dials and buttons in favor of minimalistic digital panels, and we're already seeing such touch aircon panels on the Skoda Kushaq and the Volkswagen Tiguan. So I believe we will continue to see this new design language from Volkswagen for the next few years. Is it good or bad for the driver? Well, stick till the very end. So this is the stock flat bottom steering wheel which has been sold on every Volkswagen car in India, with only minor tweaks to the buttons and trims. It is really good to hold, and the wheel body made by TRW Automotive has a good in-hand feel and is finished in a good quality leather. It's a decent wheel for entry-level cars like the Polo and the Vento, but it doesn't give Tiguan, T-Roc and Passat users that extra bling that they deserve, considering the higher price of the vehicle. And internationally, all of these three cars are offered with much more sportier steering wheel options. So I swapped out the stock steering and tried out the new electronic steering wheel, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. So this wheel has to be the meatiest, sportiest steering from the Volkswagen group that I've held in my hands. It's padded not just at the 10 and 2 o'clock positions, but also properly bolstered at the 8 and 4 o'clock positions. It's obviously flat bottom, and the perforated leather path along the sides also adds to the premiumness. It feels so good to toss around and control, and this in-hand feel is the strongest point on this new steering wheel. The trim on the wheel has a brushed aluminium finish, and it really dominates and outlines this wheel. But I don't like the fact that it doesn't feel very cool to the touch. The flat bottom end has the R-Line logo, but this is just a fancy glossy plastic trim. And it should be noted that all of these glossy plastics are susceptible to fingerprints, and I did end up wiping the steering wheel quite a number of times. You'd love the small glossy logo on the Golf airbag. The airbag has gotten smaller, and the horn pads are now not as easily accessible as the outgoing wheel, but nowhere did I find that to be a problem. Now let's speak about the buttons, which is what most people including me were curious about. And before I went for this wheel, I had absolutely no idea about what this was gonna be like. So there's nothing imprinted on the button set to begin with. It's just a glossy plastic which lights up when the ignition is on. And there is no LCD or LED interface in play here. The pre-map buttons are already present in the hardware, and in case you are wondering, there's no scope of coding to change the function or look of a particular button here. The left side is dedicated to cruise and adaptive cruise control, with a volume slider below it, while the right side houses the voice command and multifunction display control, with the track slider below. You can also get a heated steering wheel, but that needs additional hardware, and if you guessed right, the buttons with heating are a different part number. So coming to the contoured directional pads on the left and the right side, they do support a swipe gesture, meaning you can slide your thumbs up and down or sideways to control. What's worth mentioning is that each and every button can also be pressed down like a physical button, and we get a generic click from each key press. The feedback that we get from the buttons, it's definitely not as satisfying or precise as a physical key press, and in the few weeks I've been trying it, it's been really hard to use all of the buttons without causing a slight distraction. I really like the swipe gesture for the track change, but I can't say the same about the volume slider, which doesn't allow that immaculate, precise control of the volume which you'd like to have. So in no way are any of these buttons truly touch like the touch screens we use today. And honestly, these buttons are like a hybrid of all of those ideas. I believe Volkswagen could have done a better job by having a high-response multi-touch display with an adaptive haptic motor inside. So coming to the compatibility, this is a direct fit meant for the MQB platform, and on an MQB car like the Tiguan, the T-Roc, Tiguan, Passat, everything should work perfectly. But with suitable hardware and a few tweaks, I could get this wheel to work perfectly on my Polo. And it suddenly takes the aging Polo 6R's cabin right into the space age. And if you have a GTT SI, then the glossy plastics wonderfully complement the piano black trims. This wheel feels amazing on a Polo, and it's so good to hold and control the Polo with this steering wheel. I've been holding this wheel for close to a month now, and I have to say, it looks amazing, feels really good to hold and steer, and it's no doubt very modern and relevant in 2021. But steering controls are a very important interface for in-car control, and it's sad that Volkswagen have missed the mark on that front, since these are not as refined and intuitive as you'd like. And moving on, I really hope Volkswagen works on something better for their next big platform. Honestly, critical features like adaptive cruise control, they do require an immaculate control over the distance and speed that you're setting. And these new style of buttons do not give you that immaculate control that you would actually need for a safety feature like this. So that's pretty much it for this Mark 8 electronic steering wheel. Happy revving!